Getting things done is all about creating lists. So if we want to get things done, we're going to need lists. We're going to need a lot of lists. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about how I use the web app Workflowy as a part of my GTD workflow. Let's start the action. Hey, what's up, crew? This is Ita, and if we're meeting for the first time, I'm a video producer, a contract creator, and this channel is all about the tools and techniques I use to run my video business. A while back, I made a video about how to use Google Keep in your Getting Things Done workflow. And then last year, the world turned upside down, 2020. There was a lot more Zoom, a lot more wine, and a lot more not being productive. So I thought it would be a good time to reread Getting Things Done, The Art of Stress-Free Productivity. If you're watching this, I'm guessing you're probably already familiar with Getting Things Done by David Allen. But just in case you're not familiar with the GTD methodology, here's a brief summary. The core of GTD is making, keeping, and managing lists. Big or small, personal or professional, get everything out of your head and onto a list. Enter Workflowy. Workflowy is a list-making machine. It's basically a never-ending outline, and it's so simple and so clean. You can create lists within lists within lists, and there's only two sections to the interface. There's the main page and the sidebar. A few basic features are, for each bullet point, you can add a note. You can tag items with hashtags, or you can create context with the at symbol. You can search for items within a bullet chain, and you can also filter items using the tags that you create. Under this minimalist interface, there's a lot of flexibility and a lot of horsepower. Workflowy has some additional advanced features. A few worth mentioning are, you can add a date tag, you can switch from bullet mode to card mode for those of you who like Kanban boards. There's also a mirror feature, which allows you to create duplicate synchronized bullet trees. You can move those trees or those synchronized copies to other places in the list hierarchy. I could go deeper into all of the features, but let's tie this back to the GTD workflow. GTD has five discrete phases. There's capture, clarify, organize, reflect, and engage. Phase one, capture. I still use Google Keep to capture ideas as I'm out and about, whether it's a voice note or a picture of things I want to remember. But I also have this capture bucket in Workflowy to jot down random ideas as they come to me. What I really like the software for is the second piece of the capture process, the mind sweep. This is when you do a brain dump of anything that's in your head, anything that might have your attention. I sit down to do a mind sweep and just whatever comes to mind. Once I put down everything I can think of, I move on to the next phase of GTD, clarifying. This is where I take advantage of that sidebar feature. I have all my projects and open loops together in one list where I can view them in the sidebar. I love this sidebar feature. It allows me to take items from the mind sweep and then organize them into the appropriate buckets. Now, this would be phase three, organize. From there, I get into a little bit of reflection. I drill down into each project, brainstorm all the next steps and thoughts and ideas associated with it. For a long time, I was looking for one app to rule them all, one perfect app that did everything I needed it to do in GTD, and Workflowy came pretty close. There are tutorials on how to run an entire GTD system in Workflowy, but I found that that's not what works best for me. Where Workflowy falls down for me is in the engage phase. It's just the sheer amount of information that I have in there, it's just too hard to work from. While you can filter tags and context, it's just still too much to look at one time. When I was rereading Getting Things Done, there were a couple of things that jumped out at me. One was this idea of having discrete systems for each phase of your workflow. I kept hearing David say this phrase, clean edges. I'm gonna give you my final thoughts in just a sec, but before I do, let me ask you, do you have one system for your GTD setup, or do you use multiple tools? If you're not a GTDer, how do you keep track of your projects and tasks? Leave me a note in the comments below. If you'd like to check out Workflowy, it's free to get started and it works great on mobile as well as the web. You can find links in the description below. You can also find links to David Allen's Getting Things Done book in paperback, Kindle, or audiobook. Again, those links are down below. So, final thoughts. I use Workflowy to keep a complete inventory of all my stuff. It's a fast way to get things out of my head so I can sort and organize them easily. It serves as my single source of truth. That said, Workflowy works best for me when I'm in a deep dive into project planning, brainstorming, or the weekly review, not so much as a quick glance for my daily to-dos. I feel keeping my day-to-day next actions in a separate place adds a little bit more clarity. If you got some value out of this video, please be sure to click the like button, and if you'd like to hear more about how you can work smarter and not harder and get stuff done, be sure to subscribe.